Hi guys, in the last decision tree video that I made, the splitting criteria was based on entropy. So I thought of making a new video wherein the splitting criteria is Gini index. Here's a formula for Gini index. Considering two samples such as positive and negative, the value of Gini index at that particular node if we make a split is 1 minus the square of probability of positive samples in that node minus the square of probability of negative samples. Based on the individual Gini indexes that we calculate, we then further go on to calculate the reduction in impurity when we make a split based on Gini index. I'll be considering the same example as that of the last time. I have 14 samples, 4 different factors which contribute to me playing tennis or not. Considering the factor wind, there are two use cases: when there is a wind blowing and when there is no wind blowing. When there is wind blowing, I have 6 cases. 3 times I play tennis, 3 times I don't play tennis. And when there is no wind blowing, I have 8 cases out of the 14 cases, 6 times out of which I play tennis and 2 times I don't play tennis. Now, as I've already mentioned, the Gini index at that particular node is 1 minus the square of positive samples in a node minus the square of probability of negative samples in that node. So probability at, if I consider this node, the Gini index here is 1 minus 3 positive samples by the total number of samples is 6. So 3 by 6 the whole square minus again 3 negative samples by the total number of samples is 6. So 3 by 6 the whole square, which is 0.5. Similarly for this node, I'll have 1 minus 6 positive samples by the total number of samples, which is 8. So 6 by 8 the whole square minus 2 negative samples by total number of samples, which is 8. That is 2 by 8 the whole square. Calculating this, I get 0.5 and 0.375 as individual Gini indexes of these two nodes. Now I want to calculate the reduction in impurity. So the reduction in impurity is 6 by 14, which is 6 samples here upon the total number of samples here, which is 14. Into the Gini index at that node, which is 0.5, plus 8 by 14, 8 samples here by total number of samples here are 14. So 8 by 14 into 0.375, which is the Gini index that I've calculated here. So the net reduction in impurity when we split based on wind is 0.4286. Similarly, if you do it for humidity, you will get something of this sort. And your net reduction in impurity when we split based on humidity is 0.3674. Similarly, when you split based on temperature, you get a Gini index as 0.4405, or the net reduction in your impurity when we split based on temperature is 0.4405. Similarly, for outlook, which was our main splitting criteria in entropy, gives 0.3429, which is not the maximum in this case. So after calculating all the attributes, we get Gini indexes of outlook as 0.3429, temperature as 0.4405, humidity as 0.3674, and wind as 0.4286. Now considering the first split, we'll be considering gain of temperature as maximum. So we'll be considering temperature as a feature for our first split. I hope you understood how a Gini index functions. Hope you all enjoyed the video. For more such informative videos, do subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.